Hallelujah. Praise God. Now, to you, Calebs, predestinated Calebs, Revelation 3. Amen. And Revelation 22, just quickly, I'm not preaching this yet, but I just want to lay this here for them. Revelation 3:21, to him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. And also, Caleb, Revelation 22:12, and behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according to as his work shall be. God bless the reading of the word. Okay, now, Caleb. See? Now? All right. Just a few minutes here in the Pergamene church. So I don't want to take too long. I don't want to take up your time. Amen. In the Pergamene church. Amen. Page 278. Now, I'm not blind. It's been a lot of defections, family, leaving, going, coming back. You haven't heard me say much about it. The Holy Spirit told me, just keep quiet, pray for him. Amen. But I do want to say this. You pray for whom, even deacons and everybody, that you don't see around anymore. Amen. So Satan has grabbed them. Some are gone, and I don't know. They don't never call me up anyway. And anyway, but on page 278, listen to this, the Pergamene church. The message is addressed to the leader of the church. God help that guy that'll pull away from that message. That's all I got to say. So you best pray for them. Praise God. God help them. That was the individual messengers. But when a messenger would come, a prophet eagle, and bring all of their messages back as one message, God help that guy that will walk away from that. That's Jesus Christ. Yes, sir. But it was given to an angel, and the angel was in his hand under his own control, given its light and power from him, from his right hand. They're his right hand. That is, they're in supreme power while they're on the earth, because they are the lights from him, given the light to that church age. See, unto the angel. The angel's responsible if he doesn't preach the word. That's right. And the angel will have to answer in judgment. Amen. So now we got it now? God help those people that walked away from this message. I feel sorry for them. Amen. They think that some of them think they're faring well, and some only hanging by a husband or a wife or a son or daughter or something. That's the only thing that they're hanging by. That's all they got. They don't have anything else at all because they walked away. Yeah, I think, wake up in here. Oh, I feel the angel of the Lord in the camp. Praise God. Page 280. Now, hidden manna. See, I'm doing this for purpose here. Hidden manna, page 280. Now, what is the hidden manna? The manna that isn't given to all the congregation. The revelation is poured out upon the angels of the church. The revelation of the word, see? Revelation of the word is given to the angels of that age, for it's hid from everywhere else. And revealed back, the hidden manna is addressed to the angels of the church, see? You get it? It's a little bigger revelation of what Christ is, maybe a little higher call. Oh, I wonder if Luther recognized that. Wonder if Wesley did in his day. Oh, wonder if St. Martin recognized Irenaeus. Now, you know, the church didn't even canonize those men. They were saints to them. But there was the one who had the signs following. They took their own bishops and so forth to canonize. Page 281, the hidden manna is a little something special. What is the special? Oh, the blessings of the Holy Ghost. Oh, no, that's for the whole congregation. But the hidden manna was a special revelation because he had to teach the others, see? See? Was a little more knowledge of the scripture that he could teach others. He's supposed to be. Is that right? You'll never live no higher than your pastor. See? You just remember that, see? Because he's the shepherd. Now look at the people in the message, pastors that have taken the people down the road with interpretations and so forth. They couldn't get any higher. They have to come out. You see? They can't stay in there. They have to fly to another place, another valley, another mountain. Because once he preached the dove leading the eagle, that was it. Seasons changed. And they cannot stay in these places in this message. They have to come to what you've been hearing for years. See, I know it. Praise God. See, but I hope you wake up today and know it. Hope you know what you got. And come in here Sunday night and praise him. Amen. You never live no higher in your pants. You just remember, see, he's the shepherd that feeds you. If he's the shepherd, amen, he's got to know where the manna is to feed the sheep. Is that right? Now, a little special. Well, a little special, September 20th, 1974. That's all what it was. But see, that was for New York. It didn't say the whole mess. It said, watch New York. Something special about New York. What is it? Some special hidden manna. Some special hidden manna would be in New York. A little higher than the rest of the ministers. Amen. So I'm saying it today. I don't care. It's the truth. I ain't hiding and ducking no more. I'm telling you what it is. Praise God. If you don't know, maybe seated. A little special. Watch. Just a minute. The revelation, the hidden manna. Now, white rock. He shall have a white rock. This angel shall have a white stone. That's a rock, isn't it? That's right. It means purity. He met a man one time named Simon. He changed his name Peter. Why? He had the keys. Is that right? He changed his name and made him a rock. Is that right? Peter had the keys because he was the one who had the keys to the kingdom. A new name written in the rock. See? That nobody knows but himself. He knows who he is, but he can't tell others. See? No one knows but himself. See? Peter knows he had the keys, but you didn't hear him bragging about it.
I got the keys.
Peter didn't do that. Bless God, I got the keys. Huh? Praise God. Amen. See, these guys who brag about what they are is usually nothing. Amen. Amen, brother. That's it. Amen. They're usually nothing. A white rock, and in it a new name. Not his own name, but somebody else. That only he knows. That only himself knows. He's got that rock. Amen, Brother Hellman. Moses had that rock. Praise God. Elijah had that rock. And Jesus was that rock. Glory. Yes, sir. My God, I'm my God. Amen. A white rock with a new name. See? Amen. Not only that he himself knows, he's got that rock, the name. See, special manna. It's all tied together now. The white rock and the manna and the name. It's all tied in here together. So I'm just doing this before. Amen. We don't know what's going to happen, do we? Oh, praise God. Remember when this taking place in the church, it was the same age, the same time this was revealed, that the Nicolaitans, and he goes into them and how they, and when the Nicolaitans set up their leader and put a marble stone at his feet. The Pope put a white rock, a marble stone impersonation, you see? And God set up his spirit-filled leader of his spirit-filled group, his angel, and set upon him a seal of a name, but he mustn't reveal it. He must keep it to himself. No man knows but himself. Now, hidden manna, a stone, a new name that no man knows but himself, and it was addressed to the angel of the church. I wonder if Luther knows. I wonder if Wesley knows. I wonder if the other great angels. Coming in the world soon, that great angel of light that'll come to us, that'll lead us out, a great Holy Spirit coming power that will lead us to the Lord Jesus Christ. He probably won't know it, but he'll be here some of these days. God will make him known. He won't have to make himself known. God will make him known. God will prove his own. That's what he said. When Jesus was here, they didn't know him. See, he said, if I do not the works of my Father, then don't believe me. But if I do the works of my Father, you can't believe me, then believe the works. And it's going to come down to that now. If they couldn't believe the second phase, well, then the works will be done on the third phase. Well, then believe the works on the third phase. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Yes, sir. Thyatira, just doing this this morning now. It's taking a little bit of time before I get into whatever I'm going to get into. Amen. So that you know where you're coming from. Okay, you got that there. I can skip some of this here. Find out that your name has a bearing on your life, and we symbolize it. Amen. And I can't go too much on that. That's why these people name them Tahitians and all kind of strange names. I don't know from where they get them from. Amen. From Punjab, somewhere. Amen. Praise. That's what the Christian named that name, all those strange names. You know? Amen. They don't know what demons behind that name. And they name it, you know? So, amen. Give me the old-fashioned Bible, Rebecca's and Sarah's and David's and Jonathan's and Joseph's. I don't know about these new names, amen. That ain't the name, praise God. Tahisha, praise God. My God. Yes, sir, praise God. Amen. Has a bearing on your life. Now then notice, it's page 292, when that angel would receive, the angel of the church received that stone. It was a white stone, not meaning his own righteousness, but God's own righteousness. And in this stone was a name that no one knew but the one who received it himself. He knew it, but no one else could know but him. When you see these guys flatter you, telling you they're John and I'm Paul and they're Mary and this and that and the other, don't you believe it, because if it was, he'd never say nothing about it, see? That's right, he has to keep it to himself. He knowed no one knowed but himself. And he knowed because every perfect overcomer, here's what I'm trying to get to. Every perfect overcomer, Caleb, receives a new name in that way. And of course, it's in a white stone with hidden manna. Oh, praise Asha. My God. And he goes into Abraham and Sarah, why the names had to be changed, and Jacob and so forth. But when he wrestled with the Lord all night long and overcome and was blessed, God changed his name to Israel, a prince with God. Paul was called Saul until he met the Holy Spirit and the light changed from Saul. Saul, Brother Branham said, might have been okay for a king, but not an apostle. Saul's okay for some king of England somewhere, but Paul is for an apostle. Amen. And Simon was changed. Amen. And when Jesus overcame, his name was changed. And he would reveal that name. He that would be with him, overcome as he was, received a new name. And I'll reveal my new name to him. And every overcomer, I mean among such as that, them leaders and so forth. Now all the children of Israel didn't get their name changed, of course, that's right. But those high leaders, when they overcome, they had received a new name. See, that dovetails in just perfectly. And now we find out that he also got hidden manna. Hidden manna is tied to the shewbread. The shewbread for the priests alone. The shewbread was just for the priests. It was a special thing made for the priests. That is the leaders, and this man overcame. The whole congregation got manna, but he got the hidden special manna or special revelation of who Jesus was and what about him and all about him. He got that revelation. If he had overcome. See? I understand about New York. Somebody had to overcome to get their revelation. Oh, praise God. Hold fast. He had to overcome to the angel. Hold fast. He had to overcome and just to the angel of the church. Oh, my, I got it through there. Amen. Praise God. Well, blessed be the name of the Lord. I think I got it through. There's one more here. So you know that Brother Branham brought it over here. Now, on your how can I overcome? Page 32 and 33, Brother Branham actually takes all of the Revelation 2, each church age, and pulls it out on these two pages here. And page 32, he's the first church age. To him that overcometh will I give to eat of the tree of life, which is the midst of the paradise of God. See the overcoming in Ephesus. And he goes right on down the line. Hidden manna, and we'll give him a white stone, and a white stone, a new name written, which no man knoweth, saying he to receive it. That's to the overcomer of the church age. I'm just picking this out, and he goes right on down the line, and he comes down here to the verse, page 33, paragraph 156. Watch what the overcomers promise. See, now, Laodicea, that's the last church age. There's going to be some overcomers in there, and these are Caleb's. Watch this, see, remember, each church age, the one preceding it inherits all the other ones was offered. So you mean to tell me, Brother Coleman, that we will inherit all of these rewards of the previous seven church ages? Then therefore, I'm going to have a new name, I'm a white stone, and I'm going to have power over the nations. And that's right. So how can somebody sit around here all lazy and don't care? I mean, here God's offering you an inheritance that's more than all the money in the world, and is offering it to you. And then the people can't even praise a God, and they're worrying more about what's in school and what's this and what's that. Oh, yay. My God. An inheritance that Adam had. Glory. Spoken word. Spoken word is more than all the money in the world. Because you can speak their money out of here. You can say, let Rockefeller's money leave the Swiss bank. And then they'll go in there, brother, they'll have a war. Rockefeller goes looking for his money in the Swiss bank. And it's gone. See? We have the spoken word. Glory. You may be seated. See your promises? What's happening? The Calebs are coming alive on the word. My God, these are my promise. Amen. Nothing to do with Brother Coleman. Brother Coleman's preaching the word. They make me live. You may be seated. Amen. You got that now? Remember, each church age, the one preceding it, inherits all that the other ones was offered. Was offered to them, but they all didn't take it. Only the overcomers took it in each age. And so this age here, people are walking away. It was offered to them, but they didn't take it. So I assume that you want to be an overcomer. Maybe seated. Watch up here now. Now here, after they done receive all these rewards, these powers, and these new names and everything written that he promised to eat the hidden manna and all down through, watch this last church age, Revelation 3:21. To him that overcometh, see, it will sit down in my throne with my Father. There's a reward for overcomers. Press on, Lily. Yes. If it's in you, lay aside the mud and everything else and press towards the top. Yes, sir, to sit with me on my throne. There you are, Caleb. That's your commission to the Calebs. Praise God. So since you're standing, wonderful. Praise God. And Caleb, don't you forget this one here. The first seal, page 158. Give us a key for amazing grace as we go to the word. This was just a little comment, a little service for the predestinated Calebs. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. And on page 157, 158, and new first seal. I wish I could stop on that just a minute. When he said that he had a name written in Revelation 19 that no man knew but he himself. Oh, I got a good notion. Maybe nobody knows it. Did you ever know the name of Jehovah is not correct? Anyone knows that, Dr. Vail? You know that's true. The translators could never translate it. It's spelled J-V-H-U. It isn't Jehovah. They couldn't touch it. They don't know what it is. They call it Jehovah, but it wasn't his name. Look, every time a victory is won or something goes on, a name is changed. So now, if we won a victory from the first phase and went into the second one, something happened. We begin to thunder. And we have won a victory over the second phase, and we're on the third phase, something will happen. A ministry will change, or something will happen. Somebody will receive a new name. So he goes down through Abraham and Sarah and all the names that's changing, and Saul and all that. And comes down and says, and Jesus, his name on earth was Redeemer, Jesus. When he was on earth, he was the Redeemer. That's true. But when he conquered death and hell and overcome them and ascended on high, he received a new name. That's the reason they holler the way they do and don't get nothing. It will be revealed in the thunders. They are. So then if he overcome Jesus, ascending up on high, well, when he would come back, that's where he would come with his new name. And the Bible says, 1 Thessalonians 4:16, that he descended with a shout. So he himself come in the prophet with his name, new name in him, in the word, and his name is called the word of God. Now, if the word of God has been preached from the prophet's message to you, and you have received every word, then his new name is in the word. And every word of it. And all the promises. Is that correct? But it will be revealed in the thunders. Not the revelation of it, but I mean the manifestation of it. right on up to the going away, to the marking of the beast, the boycott, I mean. Watch the third pull then. What will it be? Amazing grace. Oh, don't you love him this morning? Sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Thank you, Lord. Let us pray. Father in heaven, kind of inspiration, you just kind of spoke to my heart. Didn't know what to do. Came in last night and tried to study. Devil been fighting me all week, Lord. Weary and tired. But Lord, just to be in the house last night in the room back there and feel the victory shouts and to see the young people singing like that, Lord. And my God, with a free spirit and Lord, and anointing coming down, knowing how the critics criticize us because of jealousy. Then we hear back, they all have groups, all have singing groups now, all copying. Yes, Lord, and we thank you, Lord, for the musicians, Lord, and the singers. And this morning, Sister Lisa and all the singers, Lord, and how they sang. We praise you for that. Amen. And Lord, to see... remember back how Joanne, Lord, with the inspiration up on her, how she fought and went and tried to mold these young people, Lord, into singers, Lord. Amen. And then at the right time, you had your servant Paul come on the scene, Lord, and then positionally put him there, Lord, and it was another season for her with her husband and so forth, Lord. So, Lord God, you order all things well. And how we thank God for every man in their position. So, Father, we pray now that this will be a new season for the people here. And my heart bleeds for different ones walking out, Lord, in such a time as this. And then I see Brother Courtney coming here, a sign from 83. You were calling him, Lord, and then you healed him miraculously, Lord. And then when the time came, he came in under the inspiration of another holy time coming. And he was identified. And then how he testified so beautifully Friday night to the young people. And he caught the inspiration against foolishness and jesting and all that. Lord, he knows it's a serious time. I appreciate that and his remarks. Bless him, Lord. Amen. Praise God and his family, Lord, and Trevor and his wife. And we pray for Earl that you'll clothe him in his right mind, Lord. Errol and sister, Lord, Janet, may you be with her in the hospital and the mother and all be well. Almighty God, now bless the elders and stood, deacons, ushers, translators, all the helps and governments and all their wives. We appreciate all the help, Lord. We could not have done this without them. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. Appreciate all those coming from Pennsylvania, and upstate New York, Massachusetts, downstate Jersey, Philadelphia, anywhere they come from. and come to get here for driving hundreds of miles and coming, Lord. And so, Father, this third phase, they made it. And, Lord, may you bless them, Lord. And pour out the Holy Spirit today. Oh, I don't know, Lord. You can cut me off anytime because I wanted to get this inspiration to them this season. So wherever you choose to cut me off, Lord, you just do it. Amen. So we now, Father, I'm looking for healing in the pulpit. I got one before on November 17th, an ulcer. You healed me. So I'm looking for you to heal diabetes, Lord, and give me a new strength, Lord, and good health. Amen. And Lord, seal up my seven virtues. I'm looking for it. Praise God. Amen. Now, Lord, bless the reading of the word and bless it to the hearts, to the hearers, to their souls, and may they keep it, not let any birds take it away when they go out the door. Strengthen me now, Father, for this little message to start off the third phase, and may it not stop until every predestined Caleb has been sealed away. And may the family come in, Lord. Family members come in, husbands, wayward husbands and wives or whoever they are. That's what it's for. You told me that a power will come on the earth. A voice, angel power. Amen. So I can't say no more about it. And Lord God, may that start here today. Praise God. And set these people free, Lord, from their miseries. We pray Almighty God and ask a blessing in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be, remain standing. You may open the word to St. Luke 21 and Revelation 8. Well, praise God. Everybody happy? Yeah. Amen. Praise God. St. Luke 21. Okay, verse 8. And he said, take heed that ye be not deceived, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ. And the time draweth near, go ye not therefore after them, but when ye shall hear of wars and commotions, be not terrified, for these things must first come to pass. But the end is not by and by. Then said he to them, nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and great earthquakes shall be in divers places, and famines, and pestilences, and fearful sights and great signs shall there be from heaven. But before all these, they shall lay the hands on you and persecute you, delivering you up to the synagogues. This already happened, of course, and will happen again. And to the prisons, being brought before kings and rulers for my name's sake. For my name's sake. And it shall turn to you for testimony. Sell it therefore in your hearts. Not to meditate before what ye shall answer. We're coming down to this now. For I'll give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversaries should not be able to gainsay nor resist. Just switch over to verse 25. And there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon, in the stars and upon the earth. Distress of nations with perplexity, which means no way out. The sea and the waves roaring across the earth. Men's hearts failing them for fear. See, what's the fear? They're looking after those things which are coming on the earth. For the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud, which we already seen. Amen. It's right above my head, with power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. My God, how can they sit and sleep? Here's the cloud above me right here, and it came with the angels. Right in front of you is a sign. Amen. Revelation 8, 1. And when he opened the seventh seal, there was silence in heaven about the space of a half an hour. May God bless and read of his word. You may be seated. Well, praise God. Okay, put the motors in one now. Praise God. Yes, sirree. Amen. Now I have a title, The Seventh Seal of Redemption. You better start reading your seventh seal book again. You better get back in the word. because it'd be based on the word. If you're not reading the books and hearing the tapes, I don't know where you at, where you would be at. Amen. Now my subject is the unsealing of the living testimony under the seventh seal. Amen. Now, he that is in you, from Jeffersonville. Amen. On page 9. Yes, sir. Page 9. Paragraph 43. And while the harvest is ripe, and it is, and the laborers are few, and there's hardly any, let's dig right into it right now. By chance, there might be a sinner sitting by in here this morning, and up there and down there and here. You might be sitting here. Maybe your wife is here. Maybe your husband has been here, and you want to come. Well, this is your day. Amen. This is the beginning of the third phase to pull the family in. Glory a Dios. Amen. Yes, sir. Amen. There might be someone that tonight, might change the whole course. And if it wasn't the time this morning, tonight might close the books. So don't come in there late. Might come walking down the street and the book is shut. The last one come in. Here you come waddling down the street somewhere. Praise God. Be on your post. Be on time. Yes, sir. Amen. Remember, there will not be one more come in when their names are redeemed. Now understand what redeemed means. It doesn't mean come in here and give your heart to the Lord and get baptized. That's not redeemed. Redeemed in this season is when you have gone from faith all the way to charity and been fire baptized and adopted into the body. Then you are fully redeemed. So I don't know how you can sit around on your laurels there. Praise God. That's redeemed when the last one is redeemed, has received the fire baptism. Amen. So you ain't got no time to stop. No time to fool around. This is your day. Amen. When the names. Now, everybody listen real close. Before I read the scripture, all that ever would be redeemed, God put the name on the Lamb's book of life before the world ever came into creation. How many knows that? That's the scripture. And the Antichrist in the last days is going to be so close like the real thing. Real church. Everybody just like Judas. Until it would deceive the very elected, if it were possible. Is that right? But no man can come to Jesus except God sends him. And all that God did give to him will come to him. That's why I see them go out. I said, well, God give it, they'll come. I'll pray for them. You pray for them. You don't see them around here, you pray for them. Hallelujah. Praise God. Because I ain't going out begging, persuading nobody no more. Pray, come on, your mother's there, your daughter's there, come on to church. No. Amen. My God, God's sons are called. Yes, sorry. Is that right? No man coming to Jesus except God sends him. And all that God did give to him will come to him. And when he takes that book, that last name, that's it. See, all in Lutheran age, he pull them out. All in the Wesley age, he pull them out. All in the different ages, the Pentecostal, he pulls them out. They're over here, won't be judged with them. They are rapturing. And then when the last name comes out, maybe a little baby, we don't know who it is, that was put on the Lamb's book of life, that was slain before the foundation of the world, when that last name has been redeemed. See what I'm saying now? Redeemed all the way on this brass altar. Hear ye him. When you hear back, hear ye him, you know you're redeemed. It's over. You overcome. Got a white stone. Got a new name. Shah. That should be enough encouragement. Praise God to last you until Wednesday. Praise God. That last name has been redeemed. His work is finished. You mean that the Christ got some work to do? Brother Bram said so. Dove leading eagle. From where? From faith, the virgin, as his work. Just come fresh. Amen. First he's way back in the mediatorial seat, splashing the blood. Then he tear off the seals to his prophet and gives the meat out, the food. Then he comes down in 1988 and leads the eagles, praise God, all the way from faith and virtue, knowledge and temperance. That's his last work here. Praise God. Then they fully redeem with a fire baptism, praise God. Then he claims their bodies for the resurrection. Oh, hallelujah, my God. Amen. Then his work is finished. Watch, may be seated. When that last name has been redeemed, I just explained to you, dove leading eagle. Huh? Oh, you mean the dove that was Christ back at the mediatorial seat, and he came, advanced forward from eternity, and took the book out of the Father's hand in 1963 and tore off the seal and sent it down to the prophet. Then the prophet, and then he come in the prophet, son of man, and give out the word, and went into book form and tapes. About the space of a half an hour and a little bit later, it was feeding time. Brother Branham said it was relaxing time. That's what he said when he opened, it was relaxing time. Ain't nothing going to happen. Just keep eating those tapes. See? But then it comes a time when something is going to happen. Amen. Could it be today? Oh, hallelujah. My. When that last name has been redeemed, and the Redeemer, come on, Ruth. Boaz is here. Ruth, you ought to be rewarded. Oh, hallelujah. Ruth will be rewarded. And Ruth Ristle said, that means me. Amen, Ruth. Sister Ruth, praise God. She had her eyes closed there thinking about herself. Amen. Praise God. That's right. Maybe seated. Praise God. His work is finished. Now watch. He switches. He comes forth to claim what he has redeemed. Oh, praise God. I'm laying it in here for you now. See, come forth to claim what he has redeemed. See, that makes a heart bleed. But if it went on 1,000 years later now, there would not be one redeemed. After that last one is adopted, you can go right on. There'll be no more redeemed. And still go to church. Phew. And no one can be redeemed unless they were put on the Lamb's Book of Life before the foundation of the world. Who are they? I don't know. Nobody else knows, see? Just God alone. I'm trusting that every one of us, our names are on that book. If mine was on there, I'm sure to be there. If it wasn't, I won't be there. That's all. See, that's just up to God. It's not in him that willeth, him that runneth, but God that showeth mercy. Page 10. Yes, sir. Look, did you notice those people? He talked about Billy Graham's meetings and them, you know, running down the aisles, chewing gum, laughing, punching one another. And those, some come in here, get baptized. I don't see them no more. And some Christian workers in here pushing in relatives and different ones and shoving them down the aisle. I sit there and stay and watch all that. And then they got baptized. Where they at now? Praise God. Let God bring them. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Live a life in front of them. Amen. And then they come. Amen. Give them some spoken word book. And then browbeat them for about 2 hours. Tell them it's right. All self-righteous. Amen. I know what goes on. Come on, will you? I've been around long enough to know. Amen. This here to puff people up, brother. Get a lot of knowledge. Amen. As if they had the knowledge. Amen. Praise God. Yes, sir. My God. See, I done caught them spirits, huh? Amen. Yes, sir. Amen. See? Amen. Punch another. That's That's not walking up between death and life. That's not sorry for sin and repentance. See, it's just what Billy said, Billy Graham, making a decision, and a cold, dry eye decision is nothing. See, not a thing. You got to be sorry for sin, hate yourself, and turn from it. And Billy himself said, proves that out of 30,000, you can't find 30 in a year. Said another day, what's the matter with New York? I'm reading this now. See, said the other day, what's the matter with New York? I had that great meeting there, and what happened? Sin's worse than it ever was, and will continue to get worse. What's wrong with the New York church? Third pull, seven thunders, and all the anointings. And 1983 outpouring started here with Brother Robledo. What's wrong with New York? And you walking in, walking out, and in and out, and in and out. What's wrong with New York? Sin's worse than ever in this place here, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. There'll be no national repentance. The nation is gone. Just you individuals. And soon that'll be over with, if it isn't already. Now you just mark that down, you young children. Hey, he's talking to young children now, see? See how far, Brother Branham, if it ain't Brother Branham, that what I've said is right or wrong. Sin will get worse and worse until one day the skies will catch on fire. She'll fall to the earth and the earth will burn with fervent heat, but the redeemed won't be here then. They'll be gone. And when the redeemed, my God, I won't be here, brother. I don't know about you. You can walk in and out if you want to, praise God. But Brother Coleman will not be here. Yes, sirree. Now, amen. You may be seated. Say, I ain't worrying no more because I know what season this is. And now back in 1974, Sister Coleman and I went out to Tucson. And we came back so depressed. And people followed me to the airport and said, it's like a breath of fresh rain coming out here in the desert. So I said, well, what can I do? Amen. I came on back in January 74 with the family. We were going out there. And my wife was burdened. And she kept asking, well, what is wrong with those people there? Why do they seem to be so dry and dead, you know? So on February 6th, we came home from service, 1974, Wednesday night. She was laying there. And then the voice, so this was in her heart for about a month, I guess, in January, about 2 weeks. And this was in her heart. And then God has a way of answering what's in your heart when you get quiet and so forth at the right time. And the voice of God speaking to my wife, his voice spoke, see. They have preached six seals. The seventh seal is hid. That's what's wrong. Then in her heart, a still small voice, come a revelation. But we have been feasting on the hidden manna under the seventh seal. Understand what thou hearest? That's the difference between New York City and elsewhere in the message. I hope it answers it. I hope you're satisfied finally to know the difference between New York City and elsewhere. We've been feasting on the hidden manna from Jacob, Grace, Joseph, Perfection from 1964, right straight on through. Praise God. Hidden manna. Glory to God. And some loathe the manna. I hope they don't loathe the manna. Praise God. Amen. Well, we got it. But did you catch the revelation there? Like on the day of Pentecost, Peter said, repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. For remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Now, that was God speaking through Peter. And many other words did he exhort that untoward generation. There must have been 500,000 Jews standing there on that day, but 3,000 in their heart. But you have been feasting on the hidden manna. So 500,000 heard Peter say, repent and be baptized. And the voice spoke. Amen. The voice spoke out. Praise God. They are preaching six seals. Seventh seal is hid. 500,000 people Voice spoke to them. They don't know what. But 3,000 inside. A revelation come. So the Holy Spirit said, when you get to that third phase, don't worry about them. He said, predestinated Calebs will get it on the inside. Still small voice. Well, hallelujah. I'm free. Glory. Well, praise God. I'm about preaching out already. Amen. Glory to amen. Yes, sir. Oh, hallelujah. Glory. Yes, sir. Maybe seated. The seventh seal of redemption. Amen. My subject, the unsealing of the living testimony under the seventh seal. What is the seventh seal? It's the claiming seal. Amen. It's the proven seal. It's your inheritance. It's your title deed. Amen. It's supreme authority. It's supreme control. It's authority. Amen. On the revelation of the seven seals, on the seventh seal itself. Amen. Let me read it here to you. Page 560. I'm coming back around to it now. And the Lord told me to go back to the seven seals, begin to study it on the third phase. Because now the eagles will get it. Hey, you preach it all out of season. Amen. Praise God. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, sirree. On page 560. He said, now, did you notice that one angel? I said there was a strange angel. He looked more to me than any of the rest of them. Do you remember that? They were in a constellation, three on one side and one on top. And the one right next to me, counting from left to right, would have been the seventh angel. He was brighter, more so to me than the rest of them. You remember I said he had his chest stuck out, wings swept back, amen, he was flying eastward. You remember that there? It picked me up, lifted me up. Do you remember that? Here it is, the one with the seventh seal. The big one. He had the seventh seal. Amen. The thing that I wanted all my life, them other seals, the six, see, they are preaching six seals. The six of them, see, meant a lot to me, of course. You don't know what this has meant. For one time in life, I prayed, I cried out to God after the Phoenix meeting. Any of the people there with me, I laid in the mountains. One morning, I got up and went up in Sabina Canyon, great rugged mountain, and went up there, and there was a little foot trail, and it goes on, what happened up there? You see? And so therefore, he says, here it is, the one with the seventh seal. And on page 564, he says, now, you notice now at for the end of time message, this seal, and remember, the next message, the vision said. Now, you got to tie this together, you eagles. Now, remember, the next message will be dove leading eagle. And here's the prophet saying, I'm coming back over and recycling back. Amen. This would have been way out of season back in the 70s somewhere. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Yes, yes. Now notice, for the end of time message, this seal, after all, he's revealed all the six seals. But it don't say nothing about the seventh and the end time seal. When it starts, it'll be absolutely a total secret according to the Bible. Before knowing that, remember, Revelation 10, 1 through 7, at the end of the seventh angel's message, all the mysteries of God would be known. We're at the end time. He said, all the mysteries of God, who God is, his name, and all like that would be finished with. See, the six seals would wipe all that out. Then he would come out for the seventh seal, the big angel with the swept back wings. And he would open that seventh seal. And that would be the end of time message. Now, the only way we know to find out what would be the end of time message, then that message would be laying under the seventh seal. Correcto. Amen. All the message would be known. All about Jesus, Jesus' name, baptism, all these scruples that's all messed up with these reformers be straightened out in those six seals. Amen. We at the end time, the opening of the seventh seal. Oh, praise God. But there'd be a total secret, and it was. The prophet went and preached. It was a total secret. They didn't know what he said. Amen. So then on page 567, now notice, so help me, God, I tell the truth that these are spiritually discerned to me, discerned by the Holy Spirit, and by every one of them has identified his place in the Bible. Now, what this great secret is that lays beneath this seal, the seventh one, see, I do not know. I don't know it. I couldn't make it out. I couldn't tell just what it said, but I know that it was them seven thunders uttering themselves right close together. Could that be the next message? Dove leading eagle with the next message. Oh, I see the Calebs is picking up a revelation. Exactly what the vision said. Next message, dove leading eagle. And the prophet said, I don't know, maybe seated. Oh my, too much prosperity for me. Stand up like that. I can't take it. Amen. I'm flabbergasted. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yes, sir. Amen. My. Yes, sir. Couldn't make it out. Couldn't tell. See, I feel anointed from you to Calebs now. My mind's blown. I used to preach this here. I got blanks. I was firing blanks. My God, I feel something moving. Somebody know what they're talking about. Amen. Hallelujah. Why, praise God, you can be fire baptized. Glory to God. Amen. Maybe see it. But I know it was them seven thunders uttering themselves right close together, just banging seven different times and unfolded something else that I seen. Then when I seen that, I looked for the interpretation that flew across there, and I couldn't make it out. That's exactly right. The hour isn't quite yet for it, but it's moving into that cycle. It's coming up close. So the thing for you to do is remember that I speak to you in the name of the Lord. Be prepared, for you don't know what time something can happen. Praise God. Just banging right together. Bang, 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 seven times. My God. On page 575, I could be here for weeks on this, but I'm just cutting the corners. Yeah. Just trying to, amen. Mm. My, something's happening today for sure. That's, yay. Amen. Now, on page 575. Now, do you notice on the opening of the seventh seal, it is also in a threefold mystery? This one I have, will speak, and have spoke, that it is the mystery of the seven thunders. The seven thunders in heaven will unfold this mystery. Now, he clearly tells them. Oh, he clearly tells them. He said, it opened, but not to the public. And on the anointed ones at the end time, can't you get it straight? I'm not the Son of Man. I'm a Son of Man revealing him to the public. Well, who's the thunders? He's Son of Man. To the public. But then all these false guys come along in the mess and say it's not open. It's closed. But a voice had to say it's open. And withstand these spirits, praise God. And challenge these spirits in Europe and South Africa and South America. A voice, praise God. Amen. A revelation went forth already. Now we're ready for a manifestation. Maybe they'll believe that. Maybe they'll believe me for the work's sake. If they don't believe me for the revelation's sake. Oh, hallelujah. You may be seated. Praise God. Seven thunders in heaven will unfold this mystery. It'll be right at the coming of Christ. Of course it would be. He's telling you right there, the shout, voice, trump. Because in 1963, on Jesus on Your Hands, he said, now the seventh seal is open, just waiting for it to be identified to the coming of the Lord. You got to understand the message. That was 1963. And then June 14, 1964, come to the unveiling of the mighty God. The shout on the earth. with what? The thunders. That's only the first fold of it. You saw it banging right down to that. Amen. No one would know. See, the coming of Christ, because Christ said no one would know when he would return. Did you notice when the Jews asked him that? You know, when we compared the scripture with Matthew 24 with the six seals, the seventh seal was left out. Because you see, Christ said only God himself knew. Not even the angels. No wonder it wasn't even written. You see, they hush. Nothing taking place then. Angels don't know it. Nobody knows when he's coming. But now watch. They don't know when you're coming. But there'll be, watch, seven voices of these thunders that will reveal the great revelation at that time. So these seven mysterious voices will come at that time. And praise God. And Brother Bram himself said on page 179 on the second seal, speaking about predestination. So Irenaeus was one of the angels of the church ages. As we've seen, we've studied, we believe, of course, now, they were all mysteries. They were all hid right here in these seals. They were hid there. Well, sure they were, because Paul, Irenaeus, and Martin was hid under the first seal. Columba was hid under the second seal. Is that right? And Luther and Wesley was hid under the third seal. And Malachi 4 was hid under the seventh seal. The fourth beast I was talking about. Amen. I'm speaking about beasts there. The lion was Paul, Irenaeus, and Martin. And the ox was Columba. And the man was Luther and Wesley. And the eagle was Malachi 4. And they were in the seals. And they were all mysteries. They were all hidden right here in these seals. And they are to be revealed in the last days. Now they started off with Paul and Irenaeus and Martin and so forth and come on down to the last age. And there will be seven voices of these thunders. They that will reveal the great revelation at that time. Well, praise God. They, amen. So now Malachi 4, stepped on the message was a revelation of the mysteries. And a stepped on the revelation gives us the authority, absolute faith authority, to claim our inheritance, which is our redemptive rights. Then the devils and these ministers and people in this message try to take away your redemptive rights. And there's no devil going to take it from me. I don't care where they come from. I don't care where they come from, Jeffersonville, Tucson, Pennsylvania. They are not taking my redemptive rights. If that prophet said, seven thunders give faith, I'm going to say it. And they're not going to tell me I cannot say it, praise God. Amen. That's what it's all been about. The devil's trying to stop you from saying it. Devil's trying to tear up New York City, trying to choke you up. Praise God, but we're free. Hallelujah, we're on the third phase. The dove is leading the eagle. Praise God, amen. Amen. They are preaching six seals. The seventh seal is hid. Glory. Amen. Glory. Amen, Brother Hunt. Praise God. Yes, sir. My God, praise God. God be praised. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory to God. Praise God. The fire's all over this place here. Anybody can be sealed. Praise God. You don't have to wait for nothing. While Peter yet spake these words, praise God, the Holy Ghost fell upon them as they heard the word. Glory to God. Amen, amen, amen. Praise God. Amen. You may be seated. The seventh and the revelation gives us authority. That's why I say who gave you all that authority? A seventh thunder revelation give you authority to stand in their face. Praise God. Absolute faith authority to do what? To claim our inheritance, which is our redemptive rights as revealed by the Lamb to Malachi 4 for his message. Malachi 4's message itself is a message of our redemptive rights, how we are to be redeemed back to Adam, how we ought to go back and let no devil stop us, because we are predestinated. Our names are in the Lamb's book of life. Praise God. Nobody can take it out of there. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise God. Amen. Every name in the book shall be sealed. Amen. Lord God, praise God. Praise God. Lord God, fill my brother up, Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory to God. Praise God. The fire is here. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Oh, praise God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory. Close your eyes. Praise God. Talk to the Lord. Say, Lord, seal me now, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. The fire baptism is here. Glory to God. Don't look at me. Pray, look at him. Glory. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. Yes, sir. Courtney, God's blessing you back. The devil tried to discourage you. Praise God. Now God has blessed you. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. Yay, 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 yay. Yay, say it, the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Glory. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. God be praised. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Praise God. Oh, my. Woo. Praise God. Glory. He's here. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. Yes, sir. Oh, yes. Glory. 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 This is the third phase. Come on, you Calebs. Amen, John. Praise God. Glory to God. Amen. Praise God. Ooh, yeah, amen. Praise God. Yes, sir. Glory to God. Seal them away, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. Amen, amen. Yes, sir. Come on, you Calebs. You're predestinated. Praise God. You eagles, to receive the fire baptism of the Holy Ghost, to give you a revelation, to claim your inheritance as revealed by the seven angels of the seven church ages in the Malachi 4 light, to become adopted sons and daughters of God. So saith the Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah, praise God. The fire is here. The third phase has been identified. Hallelujah, praise. What is it? Hallelujah, glory to God. Glory, glory, glory. A seed has come to you to bring forth a manifestation of the dynamics to your mechanics. A real fire baptism. Here it is. Hallelujah. Lord God, refill Joanne. Glory. What is God trying to do? He's trying to seal up your boxcar. The believers are now being filled with the seventh thunder revelation. This revelation will load up your boxcar. The seventh seal of redemption. The believer is sealed with the revelation of the first fold of the seventh seal, which is the seven thunders. Malachi 4 clearly said at the first fold of the threefold seal was uttering of the thunders. Then you can find a place, praise God, and you found a place. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory. When that seventh seal of redemption is finally open to the public, what happens? The mystery of God, a seal in these mystery seals, is finished. Oh, hallelujah, praise God, God be praised. Glory to God. Amen. The seventh seal being broken, the unsealing of the living testimony under the seventh seal. Hallelujah, praise God. Amen, praise God. That's when adopted sons of God step forward and reveal the content seal up under the seventh seal, which is the seven living voices of thunder. The manifestation of the sons of God will reveal the contents under the seventh seal. They shall be a total and a full redemption by Christ. This is a hidden mystery only to be understood by the unsealing of the living testimony under the seventh seal. Oh, thank God. Hallelujah, praise God. The third phase is here. Just think, Bride of Christ, we're here. Hey! Glory! Hallelujah. The Ark of Testimony, which contained the living testimony, was revealed by Malachi, for as the Word of God and the presence of the divine Ark is the life of the virgin bride. Therefore, the Ark of Testimony, which contains the living testimony, is in New York City. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory. Yay. Praise God. Amen. God is sealing his people. God is pouring out the Holy Spirit. The bride will be brought forth on the third phase, sealed with the mark of divine authority, and brought forth after the flesh, endowed with the seven spirits of God, which is the seventh seal of redemption, coming forth to claim his bride by a fire baptism, to claim her body for the resurrection. We are redeemed now. Raise your hands and praise him. We are redeemed. But now he's here as a dove to claim your spirit, to claim your body for the resurrection, and then it will take total possession. Come on, musicians, praise God. The Holy Spirit is here. I can't preach no more. Amen. God wants to seal the people. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah, praise God. Yes, sorry. Oh, glory. Amen. Hallelujah. He's here. Praise God. Glory to God. Glory. 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 He's here now. Oh, people are being sealed. People are being refilled. This is deliverance. Tonight, may the Holy Spirit pour out the same way. Amen. Brother Junior, praise God. Amen. It's here. The third phase is here. The seventh seal of redemption. He's here to claim your spirit, claim your body. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Redeem means to bring back. You were there before the foundation of the world, and now he's come down here to redeem you. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Lord God, I ask for my healing now, Lord. Father, may this diabetic devil, Father, may you heal me from the top of my head to the bottom of the soles of my feet. Praise God. Lord God, may fire go through me now. May you seal up my seven virtues. Oh, hallelujah.